Due to COVID, we have to conduct elections many a times at small scale for our organizations. So how can we have this election? There are many forums available. One of this forum which I am going to discuss in front of you, go to Google, just go to with your email ID which you want to sign in, you create an election. So just create election and now name this election name. So this is University Senate election, so you can write it as University Senate election, and you can give voting starts at, voting ends at. So you see we have mentioned here November 25, the timing, this is basically this is UK time, so you can adjust accordingly. And now we proceed next. So an election with short name already exists, so it means I need to name it Senate 1. Next. So now we'll create question that to whom we need to vote for. So here you can give options. For example, we need 4 Senate members, so you can give maximum options up to 4. You add a question, select one candidate for the Senate, and now I am going to write the names of these candidates. First name is Robertson, second name is, and third name is Malia, fourth name is Shashi, fifth name is, in this way, fifth name is Robin. If you have more name, you want more names, so just add here. Okay, if I'm keeping it as short Sharma. Okay, and let's take these 6 names. No, this question is added. Let's move to the next. If you want to add more questions, just you can have another question here, but. Okay, that's okay. Now if we want to add another question, okay, add it here, otherwise go and back to election. So you have question created here, you can click on this question is here. Now we need to upload voters and ballots. So I'm going to basically upload voters and ballots. Here you see I have created a list in CSV form. Please remember CSV, first name, single name will be in the first column, second column will be emails, third column may be long name. So I have created an election that is I am going to upload here, CSV file, comma separated values, go. So you see, yes, let's go. So it is processing. So you see I have created 2 of my emails and I have uploaded this voters list. Okay, now once I have uploaded a voters list, go to update. Okay, back to election. Freeze ballot and open election. No, freeze the ballot. Now your voter list has been freezed. Your voting process will start. Okay, how will voting process start? Okay, this is yet not. Okay, again voters and ballots, and send email to these voters. All these voters will get an email. You see, if you can see this my email box, so this is mentioning that your University Senate election email is there. So here I have my user ID, and here I have my password which I am going to copy, and I go to this University Senate election and I am going to vote here. I am going to vote here. I can click on this link and now I can vote here. Okay, go start vote. I am going to pick one. I can make it up to one and proceed, but I cannot make more than four. You'll get a message here, oh, maximum four. So proceed, then submit this vote. This vote has not yet been submitted unless and until you just give your password and ID correctly. So I have to see here which is my Asghar, and I have to go here, Asghar. Cast ballot. So my ballot is casted. I'll show you. So you see, in this case we have two votes here, and no one can, even other than me, no one can tell who I have voted for whom. This is a very secure system. You can go to privacy and you can go to frequently asked questions and all these on this website to find out the policy. Okay, one thing here is there is a very small problem, that if you can vote it more than once, but your only last ballot is counted. Only your last ballot is counted. If I go here and I again click on this one, okay, Control C, I again click on this link, I vote. So you see, start, and I am going to vote this time. First time I have voted twice to the same first four. So I am going to proceed. Submit. This time my password ID name is Asghar, and I have cast ballot. Never. You see, my KK is my last letter. So if I go to election information, so you see, this KK is my last one. So your last ballot will be counted. Okay, now we'll go for how we compute results. Wait for a minute. Let's go and see how our results are. Okay, let's refresh. Now you see, this election has been closed. So just go to compute encrypted tally. Compute encrypted tally. Okay, it will take a few moments. Okay, result will be released soon. Result processing is underway. So it's underway, and we refresh this, and let's refresh this. Okay, compute results. Compute the tally. So this is your result. I have voted twice to this, and one second time. So this is how you can conduct this election. I repeat, create an election, create a question, upload voters and ballot, freeze it, send an email to voters, and then set your time, and after that time you compute encrypted tally and release the results in front of your audience. Thank you. Take care.